Class 8, today we are going to start with speech writing. So what is actually a speech is? Speech is actually presentation of your ideas, your viewpoints, and when you are going to present your views and your ideas in front of gathering. Suppose number of people are there, okay, mainly in any function, okay, being held by the institutions or by organization. There the chief guest has to deliver the speech. It will be a different one. Okay. But here to what kind of speech we are going to deal is that of, you can say speech. Yes. And it is going to be related like which you are going to speak in the morning assembly. Suppose a topic is given and you deliver your views. So how you write down speech? Okay. Actually, it is meant for speaking purpose. But as you have to, for assessment in exams, you have to write down the speech. It means, first of all, you will write down, you will formulate the ideas, only then you will speak. Okay. So you should be very much careful about formulating your ideas, that what are the different type of ideas that must be included in case of speech writing. Yes, for speech writing, beta, just be careful that you will use conversative language. What kind of language you will use? Conversative language you will use. Conversative means you will involve the audience with you. Okay? Like you will make eye contact also. When you will make eye contact, the audience will feel attached with you. They will listen to your views. What ultimately our point is to deliver our views. How we will deliver? When we are going to make an eye contact, involve them in our discussion, ask them some kind of rhetorical question. Do you know that this is happening? Are you aware of this fact? It means certain kind of expressions are also used in case of speech writing. So first of all, we will write down speech. Now, before starting this topic, let me tell you, your chapter one is complete. Narration is done. Letter to editor, two letter to editors are there. You have left the space. Letter to editor, leave the space and then start forward. SNE heading, likhe chhod do, then afterwards I will do and you will forget. Okay? So now let us start with the next topic, the of writing skill, that is speech writing. Okay? So what actually a speech is? Okay? So write down, first of all, a speech is written. To present your views. Okay, so why you are writing a speech? You are writing a speech to present your views. Yes, your ideas. Okay, you present your ideas, your views or opinions. In front of gathering. In front of gathering or audience. One and the same thing. In front of audience or in front of gathering. It means like that, in front of audience or in front of gathering, you are going to present your views. Okay? It is mainly meant for oral presentation. It is meant for oral presentation it is mainly meant means I told you that mainly it is meant for oral. We have to orally present our views, but for that we have to write down. Okay, first of all we write down, then we come to know what I have to speak. Otherwise you won't go to the stage and speak whatever comes to your mind. Organize ideas. The ideas must be organized one. Okay. And one can use informal tone. To write a speech. So what you will use? You can use an informal tone when you are writing a speech. Okay? Informal tone can be used while writing a speech. okay? So clear? So this is clear to you? Let us start with the format now, okay? So in a very neat writing, you will write down format. So here I am going to make everything clear to you. Format of speech, right? For format of speech, first of all, you can start with formal address. Or before that, you can here start with any quote or quotation. You can write down quote or quotation, or you can give some interesting information. Your work is complete now. Okay, continue with that further. Okay, quote and quotation. Why you are giving it? To draw the attention of the reader towards yourself. Oh, sorry, attention of the listener towards yourself. So that the listeners will pay more attention to you, whatever you are saying. Quote and quotation. Formal address. Okay, so in formal address, what you will write down? You always begin your speech. Okay, always begin your speech with formal address or with addressing. So it's by addressing. Chief guest. You will address the chief guest. Okay. Or principal. Dignitaries. And fellow speakers. Fellow speakers means the other speakers who are also there, who are going to present their views, right? So this is very important, formal address. And after giving, for example, you will say how you will give formal address. Good morning, I dash and dash, or I Samardeep of class 8D is going to, or I got a golden opportunity, like you people are always speaking. I have got a golden chance. I have got a great chance to display my views. Okay. But on the topic, it means you will announce your topic also. Okay. When you are announcing your topic, what it means that you are going to make formal announcement of topic. Make announcement of topic also. Announcement of topic. Okay. So what it means? It means that you will clearly explain or clearly mention the topic that I'm going to speak on this topic, so that the audience will come beforehand, come to know what he is going to speak. Okay. Clearly announce your topic. Okay, it means that you will speak today, I dash and dash going to speak on this topic. Yes, beta. Meaning of dignitaries, other respected personalities who are present at that time. Because suppose in school, so you have principal, ma'am, respected teachers and your friends. But if you are going to speak in some other function, maybe some other great personalities are also there. So these are the dignitaries. Okay. Right. Next, afterwards, I'm not rubbing the lower part. Start with interactive questions. Yes. What you will do, you will start with interactive questions. Okay, start with interactive questions. What kind of interactive? Yes, do you know or are you aware of the fact? Okay, right? In order to make your speech interactive, use some general questions to the audience, okay? And also give answers to them, okay? Ask some general questions. It doesn't mean, suppose you have asked, are you aware of this fact that this is happening? Or for suppose number of people are very happy to eat fast food in the evening. So it doesn't mean that you will wait for the answer of the audience when they will say yes, no. It's their choice. But you will give the answers to them also on your own. Right? Okay? So I'm getting aside. Ask some questions and answers them also. And what you will do, you will answer them also. Okay? So that no gaps are created. Okay? So that no gaps are created. So that no gaps will be created in between. Right? So now, let me give you some examples of the questions here. What type of questions you will include? For example, do you know one thing? Who is this? Silence, please. For example, do you know one thing? Are you aware of the fact? You will be surprised to know that. ऐसे भी हम लिखते हैं ना. Do you know one thing? You will be surprised by the fact. You will be surprised by the fact. No gaps are created. So can I rub these first three lines only? First, these three lines. Okay. Or you can also say that, let us assume that, suppose we say, let us assume that this is happening and if this will happen, this will be the result. Okay, we can suppose anything. Okay, or let us take the example of, or as far as dash is concerned, we will all use these when we will discuss one topic. Okay, we will all use these. Okay, you can write on, for example, as far as this matter is concerned, okay, everyone is knowing the reality like this, okay, as a matter of fact, right, hardly do we ever know that. Hardly do we ever know that. Okay. Isn't it surprising? Isn't it shocking? Sarthak, you are not writing. Shubham. Kya name hai aapka? Shubham. Saksham. okay? Or last one, isn't it surprising? Or shocking? So these are the different type of expressions that you are going to use in case of speech writing. Okay, when you will start your every paragraph, start with this kind of expression. Okay, you will make different number of paragraphs. Word 150 to 200 words enough. Okay, then now how you will start? These are the expressions. Okay, then so when you will make body of speech, first what we have done, we have used formal address, then we have done announcement of topic, then you will start with introduction. Okay, so in introduction, what you will write down, you will, yes, you will introduce the topic. Lay the foundation of ideas. Lay the foundation of ideas. To relate to the topic, to relate to the topic. Okay, so what you will do, you will relate to lay the ideas in order to relate to the topic. Suppose you are going to talk about fast food. So how you will say, with the changing trends in society, there are number of changes in the lifestyle of people. Earlier, people were doing all the work on their own. They were cooking their food. But later on, the latest trend is spending time in the evening or hang out with your friends on fast food corners. Okay, they have mushroomed. Okay, in the city, mushroom is grown in a large size or number of grown. Grown in a very large number. Everyone likes to go there and enjoy there. It means that you are introducing the topic, right? Then afterwards, coming up to development of topic. Then, there will be also development of topic. Okay, right? Development of topic. Make one para of all major points related to the topic. Suppose we are talking about junk food. Then what we will talk, that why people eat junk food. Because it is very tasty, it is cheap, okay, consumes less time to make, many ready-made facilities are available, saves one's time, okay, it is also beneficial for those. It is beneficial for those who are living a separate life, okay. So people like to enjoy it. So you will, busy life is one of the reason for that. Okay. Then it means you have really discussed all the major points to it. Then afterwards, you will write down about, suppose you will write down about the advantages also. That what will be the advantages related to it. Okay. You will also talk about the advantages, that what are the advantages. Okay, this is what we are talking, major points and advantages also you can write. Write all the positive points. then if it has yes, in case of speech you can talk about both the positive as well as the negative aspects. If there are negative points, talk about negativities, disadvantages also. Right, disadvantages also. Okay, you will write down disadvantages also. Okay, this is separate para, make separate para. Okay, but it is not shocking for us. Like we have used the expression, is it shocking? Or it is really shocking for us that this consumption of fast food is very injurious or is very harmful for our health, as it can cause various kind of diseases. It can cause various kind of problems. Then you will discuss all the problems, right? Right, disadvantages and its and their effects. And their effects also you will write down. Clear? So when you are writing advantages, disadvantages, naturally you will give suggestions also. Okay? Give suggestions also. Right? You will give suggestions. How you will give suggestions? Like, okay? We should never deny this fact that fast food is always harmful for health. Of course, it is providing a great alternative from the daily routine of eating only, you can say, staple food. One can have it once a week or one can have it in a controlled amount. Okay, excess of everything is bad. Of course, it is true. But the fact is, when everything goes in a controlled manner, that will always last long. Okay, then you will give your suggestion what should be done. Okay, so write suggestions for the topic. Then afterwards, winding up means then start winding up your topic. Okay, it signals approaching end. Of the topic. What it signals? It signals the approaching end of the topic. It means that your now topic is going to be end, and sum up your main ideas. And sum up your main ideas. Right? Next, the last one we are having, that is conclusion. Next, what we will write down? We will write down about conclusion. Okay? So, how you will write down conclusion? Okay? Support your position. What you want to say? But if one para is left, na, then leave space for that. Give the notebook to him so that he can complete and you can continue further. Then in that conclusion one, support your position. Okay. End with the hope. End with the hope. A warning or an appeal. Or you can make an appeal. So dear audience, I hope that you are very, very, very much agree, or I hope that you agree with my viewpoints, and you will also pay attention to what I'm saying, right? And as excess of everything is bad, you will pay your most concern to this problem and will take certain necessary actions in this regard or in this manner, right? So you will write down in this way. And at the end, formal thanks. Formally thank the audience. thank you, for example, thank you for being a patient listener. In this manner, you will write down, right? So class 8, this is the basic of speech. In the next class, we will discuss one question. Okay, what to write down? And then we will proceed further. Almost same. If you have made one, then it is also fine. No problem. No need. Kyunki name to aapne apna starting mein bol hi diya, I am this and this. So no need to write your name at the end. Okay? Huh? Afterwards. So in the next class, listen to me carefully. Formal thanks. So in the next class, we will discuss the topic or one question of speech writing.